Okay, this question is asked in exam, June, July 2019 for 8 marks. See the question. Consider single server queuing system with interval time and service time given below. Stop simulation when clock reaches 23. But in this question, they never mention event handling algorithm or time advance algorithm. But you need to identify this question belongs to event handling algorithm or time advance algorithm based on the clock reaches 23. Remember it. Interval time and service time are given. So first step, compute arrival time and departure time from interval time and service time. So total interval time is given 9. So 9 plus 1 customer. Customer. So interval time for the first customer is a dash. I will write below here in exam you write on dash. So interval time for first second customer 1 1 6 3 7 5 2 4 1. Now find out arrival time. Arrival time for the first customer was 0. Arrival time for the second customer was 0 plus 1 1. Third customer was 1 plus 1, 2. Fourth customer was 2 plus 6, 8. Fifth customer, 8 plus 3, 11. Sixth customer, 11 plus 7, 18. Seventh customer, 18 plus 5, 23. Eighth customer, 23 plus 2, 25. Ninth customer, 25 plus 4, 29. Tenth customer, 29 plus 1, 30. Now calculate rate of service time as given in the question. 4, 2, 5, 4, 1, 5, 4, 1, 4. So find out departure time. For departure time for the first customer was arrival time 0 plus service time 4, 0 plus 4, 4. Now departure time for the second customer was 4 is the departure time, next arrival time is a 1, out of these 2, maximum is a 4, so 4 plus 2, 6. So next departure is a 6, arrival is a 2, maximum is 6, 6 plus 5, 11. Departure is 11. Arrival is 8, maximum is 11 plus 4, 15. 15 is there, departure, arrival 11, maximum 15, so 15 plus 1, 16. Departure was 16, arrival was 18, maximum was 18, 18 plus 5. 23. So departure is 23, arrival is 23, 23 plus 4, 27. Departure was 27, next arrival was 25. Out of these two, maximum is 27, 27 plus 1, 28. Departure is 28. Next arrival was 29, maximum is 29 plus 4, 33. So we are not working with the last customer. Once we calculated arrival time and departure time, we solved the simulation table until the clock reaches 23. So first arrival was 0. I will advance a clock 0. Event type is arrival of first customer. No customer in a queue. The first customer moved to the service. So future event link 1 arrival, 1 departure and expiration time. Its departure is 4. Next arrival was 1. write down a comma 1 b comma 4 b comma 23. BC was 0, maximum p was 0. So maximum is 1, minimum is 1. So write down 1. Event type is arrival of second customer. A2 move to the queue. A1 will move to this service. We remove arrival means add arrival. A2. So write down A comma 2, B comma 4, B comma 23. Now calculate busy time. To calculate busy time, current arrival minus previous arrival. It is 1 minus 0, 1 plus 0. Result is 1. So maximum queue is number of customer waiting in a queue. So I will write 1. Once the maximum queue is set, it is always goes on increment, or it can remain same, but no chance of increment. So from this 2, advance a clock 2. Event type is arrival of third customer. So A2 and A3 are under queue, A1 under service. So remove arrival means add arrival. So I don't P comma 4, chronological order, A comma 8, A comma 23. So busy time, again current arrival A3, previous arrival A2, 2 minus 1, 1 plus 1, 2. So maximum queue is, number of customer waiting in a queue is 2. So write down 2. So minimum is 4. Event is departure. Write down D1. So A2 is under, A3 is under queue. A2 is under service. We remove departure means add departure. So B comma 6, A comma 8, B comma 23. So find out busy time. To calculate busy time, departure minus its own arrival. 4 minus 0 plus 0 is 4. Maximum queue is 2. Even the number of customer waiting in the queue is 1, but maximum queue is 2. This maximum queue gives overall system simulation. How many customers are waiting up to 4 clock cycle? Maximum waiting customer is 2. So there is no chance of increment. Okay, there is only chance of increment or keep previous value as it is. So minimum is 6. 6. Event type is departure D2. So no customer in a queue, A3 will move to service. So remove departure means add departure D11. So remaining event write down as it is A comma 8, A comma 11, A comma 23. Busy time, D2 minus A2, 6 minus 1, 5 plus 1, 6. Maximum queue is 2. So minimum is 8. I'll advance the clock 8. Event type is arrival of fourth customer. So A4 will be under queue, A5 will be under service, A3 will be under service. So remove departure means add, remove arrival means add arrival A. All right, A11, A11, A23. So busy time is current arrival A4, 8 minus previous arrival A3, 2, 8 minus 2, 6 plus 2, 8. So maximum queue is 2. Now both having the same value, I will write 11, V5, बार थ्री थ्री बोथ इवेंट हैविंग द सेम क्लॉक साइकिल वी नीड टू अपडेट द क्लॉक एट 11 एंड परफॉर्म बोथ द इवेंट इन सेम क्लॉक साइकिल। सो A4 इज अंडर सर्विस, A5 इज अंडर क्यू। सो वी रिमूव डिपार्चर एंड अरेवल एट नेक्स्ट अरेवल, नेक्स्ट डिपार्चर A B कॉमा 15। So calculate busy time. Either you can calculate D3 minus A3 or you can calculate A5 minus A4. Both will give same result. 11 minus 8, 3 plus 8, 7. So maximum cube is 2. So minimum is 15. Advanced clock cycle 15. Event is departure of port customer. So no customer under queue. J5 will be under move to the service. So remove departure means add departure. 16. Write down B comma 16. A comma 18. A comma 23. So calculate busy time. Departure of T4 15, arrival of A4 8 15 minus 8 7 plus 8 15. So maximum customer under queue, maximum queue is 2. So minimum value is 16. So I'll advance clock 16. So event type is T5. No customer under queue, no customer under service. We remove departure means add departure. So like 8,18, T,23, E,23. So calculate busy time. D5 minus A5, 16 minus 11. 5 plus 11, 15. So maximum queue is 2. So next minimum is 18. 18. Event type is arrival. A6. So no customer in a queue. A6 will move to this service. We removed arrival means add arrival. 23. Calculate busy time. A6. A6 is a new customer to the system. Up to A1 to A5 customer came to the system and went out. Now A6 is a new customer to the system. Is keep busy value as it is. So maximum queue is 2. So next minimum value is 23. Both event having same clock cycle. So write down A7 for D6. So A6 went out. So 0. A7 moved the service. So next minimum event is arrival is 25. Departure is 27. So write down A25. B27 E23. To calculate busy time, either you can calculate current arrival minus previous arrival, or you can calculate departure minus its own arrival. 23 minus 18, 5 plus 16, 21. So maximum queue is 2. Next minimum event is 25, but estimation time is 23. We need to stop the simulation. So busy time is 21. Maximum queue is 2. problem what we solved in previous video. Along with, if the question is added, find number of customer who spend 3 or more minutes in a system, then we need to have 3 more parameter, S, N, D, and F. S is total response time of the system. N D says that number of customer got departure. F states that time customer spent in a system. This S, N, D, and F are be calculated only when departure event is occur. The remaining things already did. We just calculate S, N, D, and F. Initially, all 3 are 0. Okay. Now second clock cycle, arrival event is occur, so no need to calculate at 0. Third event is again third clock cycle, arrival is occur, no need to calculate 0. Fourth event, departure is occur. When departure is event is occur, then we need to calculate S, N, D, and F. To calculate S, departure minus its own arrival plus current S. So 4 minus 0 plus 0, you will get 4. And they say that how many customer got departure? That is, one customer has got departure. F, time customer spent in a system. According to the question, we need to find out whether the customer has spent 3 or more minutes in a system or not. If the customer spent 3 or more minutes in a system, then F is going to be incremented. Otherwise, we have to keep previous value. Here, departure is 4, arrival is 0. So 4 minus 0 is 4. So this customer has spent more than 3 minutes in a system. So make us 1. Next event, departure. Again, departure is got. We need to calculate S, N, D, and F. So to calculate S, current departure D2 minus its own arrival 6 minus 1, 5 plus 4. 5 plus 4, 9. How many customer got departure? 2 customer got departure. So F. So 6 minus 1, 5. So second customer has spent more than 3 minutes in a system. Next, arrival event is occur. So now we need to calculate, just write the previous value. Previous value. Departure event is there. So calculate S, N, D, and F. So 11 minus 2, 9 plus 9, 18. Number of customer for departure 3. So 3 customer has spent more than 3 minutes in a system. 11 minus 2 is 9. So 3 is. Next, again for departure, I can calculate S, N, D, and F. D4 minus A4, 7 plus 18, 25. Number of customer for departure 4. So again, this customer is also spent more than 3 or more minutes in the system. Again, departure 16 minus 11, 5 plus 25, 30. So 5 customer got departure. So this customer is also spent more than 3 minutes in a system. Again, arrival is there, no need to calculate, write our previous value. Here arrival and departure is there, so calculate S, N, D, and F. 23 minus 18, 5 plus 30, 35. So number of customer for departure 6. 6. So this is a problem.